The following is a class on the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Adyalila, Volume 1, Chapter 1, Text 1, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 25, 1975, in Mayapur, India.
Isha Bhaktan, Isham, Isham Taharakan, Tat Prakashamscha, तत् शक्ति कृष्ण चैतन्य संबंध कृष्ण चैतन्य इज कृष्ण दैट वाज ऑब्जर्व बाय सार्वभौम भट्टाचार्य ही कंपोज्ड 100 वर्सेस प्रेजिंग the glories of Lord Chaitanya. But because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was playing the part of a devotee, he told now the slokas, because this is not for me. That was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's humbleness. But the devotees know that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Krishna himself. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Radha Krishna Nahe Anna. Radha Krishna combination of Sri Chaitanya. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu means Radha and Krishna combined. In the beginning, there is Krishna, and then Krishna divided into two, Radha and Krishna, and then again combined, that is Sri Chaitanya. Radha Krishna Pranaya Vrikiti Alladini Shakti Asma Ekatmanavapi Deho Vedo Gato Do Chaitanya Prakatamadhuna Tadvayam Chaitkamata. So, the Goswami Siddhanta, that Krishna is one. There is no rivalry with Krishna. God is one. Eka Brahma Dvitiya Nasti. There cannot be many gods. So, when God, Krishna, wants to enjoy his pleasure potency, that is Radharani. So he manifests himself, manifests his energy and he, there is no difference. Shakti, Shakti Matayo, Abheda. The Shastra says Shakti and the Shakti Mat, when one who possesses the Shakti, Shakti means power, potency, they are equal, there is no difference. Just like the sun, sun is the powerful, and the sun sign is the power. So there is heat in the sun and there is heat also in the sun sign. There is light in the sun and there is light in the sun sign also. Therefore, qualitatively they are one, so far heat and light is concerned. But the temperature of the sun and the temperature of the sun sign may be different. Maybe not actually, there is difference. This is the basic principle of all philosophies. Achinta Veda Ved. Achinta means inconceivable. Veda means different and Abheda means non-different. The whole situation, the one is there, God, but he has expanded himself in different way. Eka Bahushyam. So that is described here. Krishna Chaitanya Sangakam. Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he has expanded himself as Guru, the Guru, the spiritual master. He is also Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sakshad Haritena Samasta Shastrai Rupta. In all the Shastras, Guru is accepted as Krishna. Sakshad Haritena. Sakshad means direct. Just like you offer your devotion, respects to Guru, so that respect is offered to Krishna. Guru also does not think himself that he is Krishna, but he collects the devotional services of the disciples to offer to Krishna. This is the process. We cannot approach Krishna directly. We should approach through Guru. Tasmād guruṁ prabhadyeta jignāsu śreya uttamam. That is the injunction of the śāstra. The one should approach the Guru who can transfer the service from the disciple to the Supreme Person. So, therefore, the first offering is Guru, Bandi Guru. Then Guru creates many devotees. Guru's business is to canvass on behalf of Supreme Lord. That is Guru's business. Krishna says, Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam saranam bhaja. You give up all material energy. Sarva dharman means in the material world we have created so many so-called duties. This is our material disease. People are interested in material engagements and they have created different varieties of engagements. Sociology, communism, and this ism, that ism, philanthropism, altruism, internationalism, nationalism, many, many duties they have created. That is all material. Krishna, out of his causeless mercy, stops the children. Out of his causeless mercy, he comes, he descends. Jada jada hi dharma sa glani bhavati bhal. Glani, this is glani. Human life is meant for one thing, adhata brahma jignasa, to inquire about the Supreme Absolute Truth. But instead of doing that, they have created so many isms. That is their misfortune. Real business is athāta brahma jignāsa. This human life, nature gives us the opportunity to inquire about the Absolute Truth. We have got the intelligence. The cats and dogs, they have no intelligence to inquire about the Absolute Truth. The trees, the plants, the aquatics, the animals, the beasts, the uncivilized man, so many, 8,400,000 forms and species of life. Out of that, the civilized man, the Aryans, Arya. Arya means the person who has got godly qualification. This is the meaning of Arya. Aryan, advanced. Aryan does not mean godless society. They are non-Aryans. Real Aryan means, because we are part and parcel of God, naturally we have got, in minute quantities, the qualities of God. that is nature. But on account of our material association, those qualifications are covered by upadhi, by various designations. This is our material disease. Material disease means just like a gold is covered by dirty things. Similarly, we are actually gold, because part and parcel of Krishna, we are small Krishna, very small, but we are also the same quality, but it is covered. This is our disease. And this covering are going on in different names, socialism, communism, and this is so many. I am Indian, I am American, I am Hindu, I am Muslim, I am white, I am black. These are all designations. So it is the business of the Guru to clear up this designation, dirty things. Therefore, Bandi Guru Isham, Guru, first offering, because he is the agent of Krishna. Krishna says that you give up all this designated dharma, take to real dharma, sarva dharmān parityajya mām ekam. That is your real business. But even Krishna does not fail, but this Krishna does not force. See, even upon the request of Krishna, we do not give up our designation. This is the difficulty. Krishna said, sarva-dharmān parityajya mām ekam saraṇam bhaja. When nobody practically except the Pandavas and few other devotees, nobody took it seriously. And what to speak of now? They are talking of Bhagavad Gita, scholars of Bhagavad Gita, but without Krishna. That is their business. These demons, they are preaching Bhagavad Gita without Krishna. Nobody preaches about Krishna. Nobody says what Krishna wants. Sarva-dharmān parityajya, Krishna wants this. But they are misinterpreting in different way and diverting the attention of the people most foolishly, that in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is the center. So this is going on. You know, you are coming all from foreign countries. Bhagavad Gita is popular in your country, at least among the scholars and theosophists and theologists, going on for the last 200 years at least. But nobody understood Krishna. That is the difference. Now, for the last, say, 5 or 10 years, because we are presenting Krishna as it is, it has become very easy for you to accept it. Unadulterated Krishna. Before this, everything was presented adulterated. Therefore, there was no effect. So, if you push on this movement, unadulterated Krishna, it will go. It will go on. And as soon as you adulterate Krishna, it will not go. It will not be effective. You may be a very good scholar or very good politician or this or that, but you will never understand what is Krishna. Nāhaṁ prakāsa sarvasya yoga māyā samāpiti. If you want to pollute Krishna, Krishna will never be revealed to you. Sevanmukhi jivhādhav swayamai vasvurta. So, by the grace of Krishna, you have taken the shelter of the lotus feet of Krishna. It is great fortune for you. So, do not adulterate Krishna. That is my request. Try to understand Krishna. And to understand Krishna, the Krishna himself taught that was also difficult. Then Krishna, as Krishna Chaitanya teaching us how to approach Krishna. That is Chaitanya Chaitamrita. Chaitanya means spiritual, living. And Charitra means character. So Chaitanya Chaitamrita means that the supreme living force, Krishna. The living force is Krishna. Therefore we contradict the so-called scientific theory that life has come from chemicals, matter. No. We are trying our best, we have engaged our scientist students. They have already, one student has already written one small book, The Scientific Basis of Krishna Consciousness, and we are going to publish another book. I have given instruction to the scientist students. What is the heading of that?
Life comes from
blood. That is the fact. These modern scientific, so-called scientific theory that matter, life comes from matter, that is not fact. Because our original person, Krishna said, Aham sarvasya prabhava. Aham, this aham word is applicable to a person. Person. And person means living force. So Chaitanya Chaitamrita means that living force. He is a person. And he is charitra, he is characteristic. This is Chaitanya. And that is amrita. Amrita means not dead matter. Mrita means dead. And amrita means not dead, living force. So, he is living force, his characteristics are also living force, and they are, because living force, they are amrita. Na hannate hannamane sarire. We have got experience what is living force and what is dead matter. That we have got experience. That is further explained by Krishna. The living force means na hannate hannamane sarire, na jayate, na mriyate kadachit. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. The living force is not finished even after the annihilation of this body. Very nice statement by Krishna. We can understand living in the life. When we are alive, the body is moving, we can understand what is living force. And we can understand further when the body does not move. That depends why the body was moving and why the body is not now moving. If we simply study this difference of position, we can understand what is living force. It is not very difficult. Simply we have to understand now this living force is gone out of this body, therefore the body is no longer moving and it is a dead matter. So this Chaitanya Charitamrita means we are talking of the living force, not of the dead matter. We should always remember. So the Guru belongs to that living force. And Isha means controller. Everyone, that living force, Gurun, Isha, Isha Bhaktan, Isha Bhaktan and Isham, so they are all living force. The Lord, His devotee, His representative, everyone, they belong to the spiritual platform, living force. Chaitanya Sangakam. Chaitanya means living. That personification of all living forces is Krishna Chaitanya. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. people mistake Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu because by misfortune they understand Krishna Chaitanya as a devotee or just like so-called sadhu or yogi like that. That is mistake. Krishna Chaitanya means the original living force, Krishna. So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he understood him. Srila Rupa Goswami, he understood him. Similarly, the followers of Rupa Goswami, Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya and all the Goswamis, they will understand Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and one who understands or follows the path enunciated by Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, for them Krishna is very easily obtained. This is called Chaitanya Charitamrita. If you follow Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu mission is described by Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sharira Dhar. Purana Purusha. I just now forget you. Vairagya Vidya Nijabhakti Yogam. Shikhartham Eka Purusha Purana. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Sharira Dhari. Kipam Vidya Stamaham. So Sri Krishna Chaitanya is the same Krishna, Purana Purusha, Adam Purana Purusha. Purana Purusha means Krishna, the original personality of God, very old. Purana means very old. So, Vairagya Vidya Shikhartham, because we are suffering here on account of so many designations. So Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came to purify us from all these nonsense designations. That is called Vairagya Vidya. Raga means attachment. So, and Viraga, this false attachment we have to give up. That is practically being manifested by practical life, how to love Krishna, how to approach him. That is the characteristic of Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and therefore he is described in the Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th canto, Krishna Varnam Tisha Krishna. Krishna Varnam, he belonged to the same category. Krishna, or he is describing Krishna always. His only business is to describe Krishna. But his complexion is not Krishna, Akrishna. Akrishna, there Akrishna means white, because Krishna had many colors. One of the colors was Pita, golden avatar. So, Tisha Krishnam Sangha Pangastha Parsadam. This Sangha Pangastha Parsadam is described here that Gurun, Isham, Isabhaktan, Isabhatarakan, Tat Prakashangscha, Tat Shakti. This is Sangha Panga. So, study this Chaitanya Charitamrita. Now we have got this English edition very elaborately described, following the footsteps of our Guru Maharaj, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, Prabhupada. There is no such edition of Chaitanya Charitamrita, very elaborately described, but it can be understood by the advanced student. Advanced student, anyone, you can become advanced. Advanced means at least one should understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. If you simply understand these two words,
that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. Then you are advanced. It is not very difficult. Everything, all Vedic literature, they are meant for understanding Krishna. Vedaishta sarvai ahameva vedam. So if you simply understand, what is that understanding? That Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. We have written in our Krishna book, Krishna the Supreme Personality. If you become convinced, then your study of Vedas finished. Stepus tapaste, Shushnu Arjya. Anyone who understands Krishna, what is that understanding? Krishna says, Matta Paradaram Nanna Kinchi Jasti Dhananjaya. My dear Arjuna, there is no more superior, authority or person or truth than myself. Matta Parataram Nanna Kinchi Sasti Dhananjaya. These few words, if you simply understand, blindly or openly, it doesn't matter. Because if you touch fire either blindly or openly, it will act. It will act. It is not that because I have blindly accepted Krishna as the Supreme Person that will not act. No, it will act. Even if you have accepted Krishna blindly, it will act. Because the thing is the same. Either you accept in open eyes or blind eyes. Similarly, if you accept this theory, this is not theory, this is fact, that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, these few words, then you are advanced to it, immediately. Take it from me, that simply this conviction, that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God, then you are an advanced student in spiritual life. So, all these persons associate with Krishna, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, Sri Nityananda, Sri Advaita, and Gadadha, and Srivas, all of them, they are one. One in this sense, they are all interested how to push on Krishna consciousness. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is trying personally, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and Nityananda Prabhu, Advaita Prabhu, Srivas, Gadadhar, they are trying to help. So, and to approach all these five Supreme Persons, you require the help of Guru. Therefore, the Guru is offered first, the respectful prayer, Bandi Guru. Gurun, Bahubachan, plural number, there are many Gurus, but they are not many, they are one, Guru Tattva. Just like Krishna has many forms, but that does not mean Krishna is different. No, Krishna is one. Similarly, Guru, there may be many Gurus, it doesn't matter. But their philosophy must be one, to teach everyone that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. There may be thousands of Gurus, but the Guru's business is to teach the disciple that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. That is the test of it. If Guru is teaching something else nonsense, then he is not good. Guru na sasyat. Satkarma nipuna vipra mantra tantra visharam. A brahmana is very expert in his business, in Vedic culture, Vedic mantras, tantras. That is the taste of the brahmana, that he is very learned. So satkarma nipuna vipra mantra tantra visharam. Visharam is a very expert. Avaishnava guru na sasyat. But if he does not know what is Krishna, or if he is not a devotee of Krishna, he cannot become Guru. Shad Vaishnava Sapacha Guru. But one person who is coming from the family of dog eaters. The dog eaters, they are considered to be the lowest of the human being. So, sapacha, sapacha means, sa means dog, and pacha means eater or cooker. So sapacha, even a person is coming from the sapacha family, and if he is a Vaishnava, if he is a devotee of Krishna, he can become guru. On the other side, even born in a Brahmin family and very expert in Vedic ritualistic performances, mantra tantra visharada, he cannot become guru if he does not understand Krishna. So, therefore, guru is very important because he has accepted Krishna, tattva-darshibhi. He has seen the truth, so therefore guru is first offered. This is the taste of guru. Guru does not become Krishna himself, but he canvasses door to door to induce that you become devotee of Krishna. This is sign of guru. Bandhi guru nisham, ishabhava. Then you shall describe later. Thank you very much.